In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this text window title animation. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We'll create all the elements, then animate the text window, and in the end, add a scribbled look using a simple expression. Alright, let's jump right in. First of all, let's create a new composition, 96 frames long, and name it window. We grab the rounded rectangle tool and double click on it. Open the rectangle path property, then deactivate constraint proportions and set the size to 900 by 400 pixels. Stroke width 4 pixels, color black. Fill white. Let's name it window as well. Then we right click on the layer, go to layer styles and add stroke. Set the color to white, the stroke width to 4 pixels, which creates this nice frame. Closing some of the stuff, we duplicate the rectangle, turn it into a bezier path, open the path property and delete the two lower inner points. Then we use the Convert Vertex tool and click on the two bottom points to get rid of the roundness. Switch back to the Selection tool and move the two remaining points up to here maybe. Then we change the fill color to black. With the window layer selected, we grab the Ellipse tool and add a round shape. Fill white. And place it here on the top shape. Then we duplicate it two times and line them up. Awesome! Let's add a pattern to the window, like some repetitive dots. So with no layer selected, we use the ellipse tool again and create a round shape. Let's name the new layer dots. Open the ellipse path property and set the size to 5 pixels. Then we add a repeater. Set copies to 18. Open the transform repeater property and set the x value of the position to 50. Let's position it. Then we duplicate the ellipse path. And as the horizontal distance between the dots is 50 pixels, we add 50 pixels to the y position to move it down. And so on, until we reach the bottom. Position the dots. Then we use the title tool to add some text. Let's go for Jill Sans Ultra Bold. Color black. Alright, position the text on the dots. Finally, we set the opacity of the dots to 50%. Awesome! That's the text window, created completely in After Effects. Let's create another comp, same settings, and let's name it Title Animation. We add the window comp to it, starting at 15 frames. With no layer selected, let's grab the rectangle tool and create the document, from which the window appears. Double click, let's change the size to 200 by 250 pixels. We name it Doc. We again add the stroke layer style, color white, width 4 pixels. Then we grab the pen tool and add some lines, indicating text. We draw the first one, then duplicate the path within the shape and adjust the position and length until we have all the lines we want. Let's zoom in here. Awesome! Finally, with the dark layer selected, let's quickly add a black corner using the pen tool, which is like typical for document icons. Let's position it using the arrow keys. And let's change the fill into black. Then we use the title tool again to add a name. Size way smaller, like 25, and the regular weight this time. Text.doc or whatever you want to name it. White, of course. And let's center it. And we link the layer to the doc shape. Then we move the two layers below the window comp and position it here, below the left upper corner of the window. We select the window comp and use the anchor point tool to move the anchor point towards the upper left corner, like on top of the left drawn shape. Back to the selection tool. Then we open the position and scale property of the window comp and set a scale and position keyframe at 15 frames. Set the scale to 8%. Then we go to 21 frames and set the scale to 110%. And set a position keyframe. At 24 frames, we set the scale to 100%. Finally, at 18 frames, we move the window up above the text document. Awesome. By the way, if you like this video so far, please give it a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks very much, guys. To add some kind of scribbled look, we use the effects and presets window and add turbulent displays to the window. Amount 4, size 20, complexity 1. That's better. Pinning, high and all, anti-aliasing, high. Then we hold Option while clicking on the evolution stopwatch to add an expression. First of all, we add posterize time, parenthesis, 8 in parenthesis, semicolon. And this expression always needs a value. So we add time asterisk 4000. So the value changes 8 times per second, meaning every 3 frames, and 4000 degrees per second. Awesome. Next, we add CC Bandit. Set the start point on the left side, the end point to the right of the window. Let's close that. We set a bend keyframe and the value to around minus 30. We press U to see the keyframe in the timeline. At 21 frames to around 10. At 24 frames to minus 5. At 28 frames to 3. At 32 frames to minus 1. And at 37 frames, finally, to 0. We select the bend keyframes, open the graph editor, make sure snap is activated and edit speed graph is selected. Then we adjust the speed curve and basically round those corners. Let's see. Awesome. Let's quickly add the out animation. We select all the keyframes, copy them, and paste them further right in the timeline. We delete the right 3 bend keyframes. Then select them again, right-click, go to Keyframe Assistant, and Time Reverse Keyframes. Then we move the position keyframes 3 frames to the right. Finally, we move all keyframes to 80 frames, and set the first bend keyframe to 0. When I first made the animation, the left corner of the window had weird artifacts. If that happens to you, change the two inner bend keyframe values to 0,1 instead of 0. That should solve it. I don't know. Sometimes weird things happen. Back to our comp. We go to 18 frames and split the window comp. Move the beginning down so that it appears from behind. Same at the end. Split the comp at 86 frames and move the end part down. Then we go to 11 frames and open the scale property. Well, 11 frames. Set a scale keyframe, then go to 13 frames, scale it down to 90%. At 15 frames, it's back to 100. That's the file reacting to the mouse. We'll add now. We use a polygon shape and reduce the corners to 3. Then decrease the outer radius to around 60. We right-click on the path property to convert it into a bezier path. Then adjust the path shape. We move the upper point further up. Let's name the layer mouse. Then we add the stroke layer style again. Like before, color white, stroke width 4 pixels. Then let's add a rectangle to complete the shape. Next, we open the rotation property and set the value to minus 35 degrees. We move it out of the screen at the beginning and set a position keyframe. At 11 frames, we move it onto the document. And quickly adjust the speed graph, slowing down the beginning and end. We adjust the endpoint of the layer and move it below the top window comp. Finally, we duplicate the shape and move the mouse back in at 70 frames. And move it out of the screen. One more time, we adjust the speed curve. It looks a bit like a capital M. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to the channel on the right side and ring the bell to get notified when my next video is coming out. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys.